We are live. And we are also on the road. Sorry we're a little late today. We've got a lot more buttons to push. But we're in a high-tech situation here. BettySoo is with us, sitting next to us. And we've got a two-camera shoot on this thing. We haven't done that before. That's a first. I didn't get a sound check. Is there any way to make this mic a little louder? Yeah, turn me up a little there if you would. And here with BettySoo and Jamie, we're in Bellows Falls, Vermont, where this morning the fire trucks drove around town with the sirens on and the lights flashing and a 4th of July parade blowing the horns. It's Independence Day in America, and there's fireworks everywhere, and in Bellows Falls there's fire trucks, and the people had a parade that went around town, I think, what did they say, three times? It's a small town, so you can't really have much of a parade if it only goes around town once. So I went around town a few times, and lots of noise. Oh, my God. So we've been on the road. Jamie and I played in Galveston, Texas, and then we played in
San Antonio,
Texas, outside, 104 degrees. And then we played in Tomball, Texas, outside of
Houston.
What else did we? There was four.
Dallas.
And then we played in Dallas, Cafe Momentum. So we're back to work. We're back on the road here. This weekend, we're up in the Northeast. We're in the state of Vermont. And it's been really weird weather. There was a couple of days of 100 degrees up here, which just doesn't really ever happen. And then for the last 3 days, it's been really raining. And we landed late Thursday night, and it's just been a lot of rain. And floody almost when we came. Well, not almost. It was the deepest water I ever drove in.
It was insane.
It was like the car was about to float on the way back from the airport at 2 o'clock in the morning. But we made it, and we're here. We're happy to have you with us. Michaela's with us, too, from Italy, and we're ready to make some music. You ready to make some music, Jamie? Yeah. Highway 90 westbound in the falling dark, rolling past cornfields, catfish farms and swamps, Pascagoula sunset, longing, breaking through. Don't know why I'm always leaving. Don't know why I left you. Won't you meet me in the meadow? We can look up at the stars, lean into the wind, dream again, find out who we are. Won't you meet me in the meadow? No more alone. We could lay down in the grass, feelings pass, then go home. It's upside down. have so much to tell you. I am ready to come clean. I don't know why I'm always leaving things I cannot leave. You and me in Mississippi, battered, beautiful and scarred, in need of forgiveness and the grace of God. Won't you meet me meadow? We can look up at the stars, lean into the wind, dream again, find out who we are. Won't you meet me in the meadow? No more alone. We could lay down in the grass till the feelings pass, then go home. We could lay down in the grass till the feelings pass, then go home. So I
the upside down harmonica, that's perfect.
I took them all out of my bag and boiled them to clean them up real good.
Wow.
And so it's upside down. I didn't put it back in right. And that happens. And this is getting old and messed up too. That's hard to maneuver.
If there are any harmonica holder sponsors out there that would like to sponsor?
Need a new harmonica holder.
Harmonica playing folk singer.
Ink. They're cheap. That's why they don't last. They
break. Yeah, but free is cheaper than cheap.
They break. Would you click it over so I can see the comments?
The comments?
Yeah.
Sorry about that.
Because I need to look at the comments to make sure I
forget the words. Yeah.
Guaranteed. To make me forget the words, I'll look at the comments. It's good to see everybody here. I really wasn't expecting folks to show up today since the holiday. Everybody's doing, barbecues and cookouts. And what's the tradition? Do y'all have a tradition in your family for the 4th of July?
Not that I can remember. I mean, Jell-O. Just eating Jell-O.
Jell-O?
Yeah.
What's your favorite kind?
The blue color.
Blue?
Whatever.
They have blue Jell-O.
Yeah, it's like a blue raspberry. You know, I made that blueberry Jell-O dish that one time that is like, blue. This is such a Baptist...
It's a Baptist
Southern
after Baptist church food
special. I wish BettySoo's face was on the screen. It's so horrible. She's horrified. But yeah, you make it with like blue raspberry and blueberry Jell-O and then blueberry pie filling and then cream cheese. And
yeah.
It's so good.
Oh, you did make that?
Yeah, it was really good. When I was doing the artist way, and part of like one of the things to do is to like eat a food from your childhood.
Comfort food from your
like making this weird Jell-O casserole. Yeah.
Yeah, I remember you made two big dishes of it, and I ate almost all of it.
It's really good.
Because you put cream cheese in.
Yeah. But, I mean, and pineapple. Canned pineapple is the other thing. It's really good. But, I mean, we would just go down, like, to the suspension bridge. It's called Indian Springs Park.
Waco, Texas. We watched that bridge, right? Watch the fireworks?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah. And the town would have fireworks on the river.
Yep, exactly right.
Every town with the river has fireworks on the river.
Mm-hmm.
Although they're not doing them, I don't think they're doing them on the river in Boston this year. They're doing them at Tanglewood, which is in Western Mass. They're not doing the symphony on the half shell this year. They're going a little safer, more spread out. Because that's madness. That's like 100,000 people jammed in shoulder to shoulder. It's a little nuts. But we're going to go to Harlow Farms, an organic farm here in Bellows Falls, Vermont, for a nice dinner. Organic vegetables and what else do they have? They have chickens, right? They got chickens and
hot pepper jelly.
Hot pepper jelly.
Pork and all that, everything.
All of it, right? Antibiotic-free meats. It's a wonderful farm. It's kind of a tradition. I usually play here in the summer at a festival called Roots on the River. And that's not happening this summer, but we came to see friends, and we're going to go to Harlow Farms and have our traditional summer gathering of friends and food. I'm up a cape, I'm up a half step.
Cool.
You want me to go back down?
No, that's cool.
I'll go down.
I don't know what song you're playing.
Between Daylight and Dark. Well, the grasses are swaying. Sun's going down. Music's playing. You're weaving through town, pulling into the driveway. Tossing par. Stare out of the windshield, out into the world. It was all for the love of a reckless girl who left you with a second place smile and a broken heart. And the street lights are starting to flicker to life. They glow for a minute, then they get bright. Fireflies light up, circle and spark. There's nothing that you can do. Put your hands in your pockets. Try to get through the distance between the daylight and the dark.
Pick it, Harris.
Front porch flies lie themselves down like forgotten soldiers or old wedding gowns in closets unopened and graves without any mourning. As the night curves lower behind the rooftops, shadows dance across the sidewalks, ricocheting off of the houses like pieces of art. And your mind is reeling as the sky is changing all. Climb back in. Fire the ignition. Put your hands on the wheel. Head into the distance, the distance. Playing. That was beautiful.
Thank you. I like the setup where you can actually see our guitars. That's cool. It makes me feel like I'm on a real TV show.
We gotta make that happen at our house.
Yeah.
I don't know how to do it with the camera we have. It's, the problem
is that the desk is so close to the wall.
We're in a little bitty situation in my office that we usually broadcast from, and we have a camera that's mounted on top of the desk. Top computer, and so there's not a lot of room to get a big full shot like you've got here.
But we have to compensate with the flag.
Yeah. Let's play one more and see how Betty Sue's doing over there.
Okay.
Welcome everybody who's just getting with us. We're in Bellows Falls, Vermont. Happy 4th of July, Independence Day. We're happy to be with you today. We are live from Charlie's library, we'll call it. A lot of first edition books behind me. Quite a collection of interesting stuff. I love books. Speaking of books, my book comes out on Tuesday.
Yes, on Tuesday.
I can't even believe it. My book is available on Tuesday. If you pre-ordered it, it should be showing up in your mail on Monday or Tuesday. I don't know how it all comes together, but they said they would appear on release day, so I'm not in charge of them, whoever they are, but whoever you ordered it from should have it to you this week coming up. It's exciting for me to begin the process of being on a book tour, which is going to consist more or less of Zoom interviews with interesting people for the next 2 weeks or so. I'm excited about it, and looking forward to learning about book world, of which I know very little except as a consumer. I don't know anything about book world as a creator, but I'm definitely a book lover, as is Michele and Jamie too. And we go to a lot of bookstores when we're on the road, and we always end up overweight at the airport because of books. We love books. Then there's the whole phenomenon of audiobook, which I did read. I read my own audiobook and was interviewed in a special segment by Amy Ray from the Indigo Girls, who contributed really nice questions to the audiobook. I can't wait to hear them.
Yeah, Mary came back from the interview just like glowing, and you were just talking about
it. She was so gracious and so honest. She was an open book herself. She really was open and talking about what it was like to be her when all hell broke loose and they got famous. And I wrote about that quite a bit in my book, how the Indigo Girls impacted my consciousness about what was possible in the music business. And so many people were inspired by them, including me. And she gave me a little inside look of what it was like to be her at the time, which was surprising to me, what was going on inside of her. I wouldn't have expected what she said. It's not what I would have thought.
Yeah,
we think we know everything when we look at people. Actually, you gotta ask them how they're doing to find out, and even then you might not get an answer that's legit.
Fine.
I'll think about the joy inside your laugh. I'll think about your hand in the sad mind. I think about the softness of your sweet skin while I try not to think about time. I'll think about my arms wrapped all around you. I'll think about the kindness in your eyes. I'll think about how you showed up my doorstep while I try not to think about time. So many roads, so many times between. So many stairs to climb. So many thoughts to think as I miss you. And I try not to think about time. Nice. Play yourself in. in there, Betty Sue, and let's see you. Is that something we can do?
Oh my gosh.
There you are.
Oh my gosh.
where I don't see it.
She's
oh,
there
hi.
In the corner.
She's actually right she's next to me.
Picture in picture.
Aww. So she's right next to me. I'm very excited.
I'm sitting
about
here on Jamie's lap. Yeah. Mini me.
Nope. I can't figure out left and right. Okay, anyways.
Are you ticklish?
So how long have you been here in Vermont? I know you've been in Austin for the majority of the pandemic. So you
Yeah, can... I was pretty much locked down in my house for over about a year and number of months, and then I came up here just about a month ago and have been up here with Charlie. It's been so nice.
Yeah.
It feels weird. I want to talk to you like this.
I know.
But then
I realize.
Then everybody thinks I'm just like not looking at anyone.
I'm looking.
So you've been here about a month and you've mm-hmm. settled in this sweet little town.
Yeah.
It's
I
an
love
old,
it here.
It's an old mill town.
Yeah.
And it like so many New England towns, the mills are long gone and they're trying to find their way back into a community of thriving people. I think there's a small arts community that's starting to form here. Charlie's certainly helping with that.
Yes. Yeah. He's very involved in the town and volunteers a lot to try to make it a good place for everybody. And I think he works hard, and it's an inspiration to me to see that kind of involvement, because I always grew up, I mean, even though I grew up in Spring, Texas, it was still like, you know, big. and I think I always felt a little bit disempowered and like what can we really do to make that big of a difference? And then it's such a reminder to me that like everybody can really make a difference in their community, just watching him.
Yeah, to see hands-on in a small community how it really does. We really are a democracy from ground up in small communities all the way up, and if you get in there and do some work, it has an impact. Your voice will have an impact mm-hmm. if you're persistent, especially in I think at the local level. So so here we are, and here you are. Thank you for setting up this technology so that we
yes.
could do this today. I really
oh,
appreciate
thank you.
It.
I'm so glad to like actually be in the room.
I know.
Musicians, like it's such a treat to be here with you guys.
You know what would be cool for me, mm-hmm. and I don't know if you want to do it, and if you don't, you can say no, is for you to play a song that Jamie can sing on.
Oh yeah,
we
could
we
do
have
that.
Two
I mean,
mics.
At some point, you've not,
yeah, yeah.
We could do that. Like,
let's do
oh
it.
My gosh, yeah.
That'd be fun.
I'd like that. Please.
Also, want to say thank you, Betty Sue, for helping us support the local economy of Bellows Falls, Vermont today by taking us to Jim's Arcade.
That was so fun.
Where Betty Sue, what, Gauthier, you won at skee ball, right?
I won the skee ball.
She won skee ball.
I won pinball, and Betty Sue won the
wacka alligator.
Wacky gator.
We went to the arcade this morning, and
that was a blast.
It was like finesse, coordination, rage. You know, that was basically what it came down to.
We do have short videos of all three of us hitting the whack-a-mole game, and when they all start coming up, you can't help but sweat and get excited. It's really, it's adrenaline-inducing. You start banging hard.
My heart was pounding and I was screaming
yeah,
the whole
yeah.
time.
It was very
so
fun. Very fun. Cool, so do I need to pull you...
Oh, should I go big screen?
Yeah,
go
okay.
big screen.
Yeah, go big screen. And Jamie will sing from over here. Hey,
there
you are.
Okay. All right. Well, let's think. Oh, I know. I know what to do. You know what? I'm going to make Jamie... little.
Okay.
Oh, that's cool. That you know how to do all that.
Hold on a second.
Yeah, I wish we had another stream going of the technology, because it's really...
There's quite a bit of technology
it's
going
cool.
on. There it is. There
Let
we
me
are.
See. I'm going to stick you over here. I don't know. I'm trying to figure out how to
Hey, that
have
works.
Share.
Look at there.
Perfect. We'll be on top of each other.
Love it.
What's crazy is we're sitting right next to each other, but you can't
But we tell. Can't all
but we
get
can't
into
get
the same screen.
Shot. Yeah.
Does that work? Is that super goofy?
Let's do it.
I'll just try to stay in this slice. Yeah. Oh, wait. Duh. I can just do...
There we go.
Okay. Duh. All right, guys. Hold on a second. I gotta point this way. Things, all the stuff.
It's comfortable. I feel comfortable. Yeah, good. This is amazing that you were able to set this up for three people.
Yeah, so that we didn't have to fly. Thank you.
No, it was fun.
I saved this a suitcase.
I did set this to be a shadow right on my face. So that was not a pro move, but that's all right.
It sounds good.
Yeah, it sounds great.
Am I playing another
song? Yeah, okay. It's fine. You can take me on it if you
want. I'm going to do a Nobody's Girl song, actually. Cool. So... maybe I will go big. Go big. Nobody's Girl, we're releasing this is my band that I have with Rebecca Lobie and Grace Pettis. And for any of you who are watching from Austin, go pick up a paper today, a copy of the Statesman, because we are like the entire front of the entertainment section.
Yes,
an enormous picture of us. We are Artist of the Month for Austin 360, which we are so honored by. Thanks to Peter Blackstock for this amazing write-up, and he's telling our backstory as a band. And we had no idea it was going to be like above and below the fold. It's amazing. Awesome. I don't think I've ever had such a giant picture in a paper before. So it was very fun. But this song is going to come out just near the end of the month, just when the record comes out. So. Hope it resonates. First you learn to breathe. Nobody has to teach you. just Ivy need to climb, or is it just her custom to leave the ground behind, lingering and lonesome? Where you run into? Where you run into? Run wild, run free, run to where. Into the morning, where'd you leave your nest? Did you wing off without warning? Where you running to? Where you running to? Run wild, run free, run to where you need to be. Maybe one day you'll run home to me. It's gone rushing now, and the bumblebees returning. Geese are flying south, April skies are storming. Where you running to? Where you running?
So with Nobody's Girl,
mm-hmm.
do you all write, it's a trio of three women singer-songwriters.
Mm-hmm.
Do you write individually and bring songs to the group, or does the group write songs together?
We rewrite everything together.
That sounds harrowing.
It's it's sometimes quick and full of kismet, and it's sometimes a battle. But we are always... I will say all three of us have, even when it has gotten, you know, frustrating and tensions running high, once we have settled on a song together and decided that it's done, or at least that draft is done, we're all so happy. Like we just transition like that to just utter joy and happiness and gratefulness and thankful for each other, because we're like, okay, yeah, duking it out was worth it, and we love what we did, so...
It's a birthing process, and there's pain involved for sure.
There is,
if you're
for
by
sure.
yourself, it's not exactly painless, but right. with a three-way co-write, that can get quite... I've done a few, and it can get quite harrowing.
Yeah, you know, I think the most surprising thing to all three of us is we'd all done co-writes with, you know, one or more co-writers, but we'd never done it for a group that you're going to be singing those songs with.
Yeah, that's a whole other
thing. And we realize that's a whole other thing, because it's not like she'll sing that line that way, I'll sing this
yeah,
line
exactly,
this way.
Yeah.
You know, when we go off our separate ways, there's none of that. There's, we've got to make peace about how it's going to be done on stage together. And that's none of us were prepared for how different that was.
You're all three very, you have your own vision. You're strong-willed and smart women. There's
that
not anybody.
We are.
Yeah, there's not anybody in that group that's just like, oh, whatever you say is fine. There's none of that going on.
Yeah.
There's people with strong vision and opinions and musical sensibility. So.
Well, thanks. Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Not a shrinking violet among us.
Not a shrinker amongst you. Oh, that's a beautiful song. Congratulations on the big spread in the paper. It's exciting when that happens.
Thanks so much.
It's nice when they give. Give you space. Frame it. At the downtown near the Roosevelt Bank.
Get you.
trouble and love. Like red beans and rice, they go together. Peanut butter and jelly. It's a combo thing. I think we should go to Italy and see how the maestro is holding up. Michele!
Welcome to Italy.
Where are we with those t-shirts?
We went to the north end of Boston day before yesterday to my favorite little place, Cafe Vittoria, and we had cappuccinos, and we sat down, and we looked at each other, and we said, welcome to Italy. And we toasted to you, my friend. We miss you. How are you?
I'm fine. Obviously, I am jealous because you are there on road. You are also in Bello Falls, one of my favorite places in the world, with my friends, BettySoo, Charlie, the Harlow family, Lori. Say hi to everybody tonight. I always remember the fantastic dinner at the Harlow Farms and the kindness. I remember one incredible thing, Lori and all the friends in the family. When I was there the last time, 2 years ago, for my 50th birthday, they found my favorite wine in Italy there. And so I had my favorite wine on the table there at the Harlow Farm. You remember? That was unbelievable for me.
Incredible.
It was a really beautiful touch. A very thoughtful, kind people. And incredible farm up here in Bellows Falls. Yeah.
Yes. And that's just one thing. They are such a nice people, nice person. I want to personally thank Lori now because she always kept in touch, writing nice thing, nice letter, helping me also with my translations in English. So she is just a fine, fine person. So I send her love and to all the family there. I miss them.
We feel a little guilty being here without you, to be honest. It doesn't feel right. It doesn't. Well, there's a seat at the table that should be yours. And it doesn't feel right having you all the way over there for this dinner tonight. But I have a feeling next year you will be at the table.
I hope so too. But I have also good news. 2 days ago, I had my second shot of the Pfizer vaccine. I'm feeling great.
Yay, Michele!
And also, I have this piece of paper that is really important in Europe because I can go around in Europe. It seems. With this piece of paper, it's like a green pass to move. So this is something.
So is that a vaccine passport? Is that what you call it?
Yes. It's a vaccine passport. Obviously, there are problems in England, so I don't know if the thing will really work. But anyway, it's nice to have this piece of paper, this vaccine passport for Europe. For sure, for the southern part of Italy, it works. Italy, France, Spain, Croatia, here around Italy, Germany, Switzerland. So it's something.
So if you get work, you can go play.
This is the meaning of this. So, and I'm really, and I'm really obviously happy for this.
We're very happy for you.
Yes, and I can move a little bit. Yes, I can play a concert. For now, they are few for me personally, but I can also go I can also attend other people's concert, and this is precious after 1 year and a half without all these things. So I am happy. So I hope to be there with you soon. I have also a commercial to do because next week it will be out. My favorite book of the year, so I suggest.
Thank you, maestro. Thank you.
Yes, It is actually. So it's a great book about songwriting, and not only about songwriting. So this is about being alive in this world and try to survive and do something for yourself and for other people. So it's a great book. So I suggest it. It's a great book.
Thank you, Michele.
By the way, today I will perform an instrumental thing on the violin that a friend requested, actually. It's one of my compositions that is on the album The Salt Road. And it's the last track on that album. And it's also there an instrumental piece of music, violin alone. I love it too because it shows the different souls of the violin that can be really in the meditation level, but also can be dance. It's a popular instrument, it's a classic music instrument, it's a Jewish, Gypsy. So I think this is, I think, as I said one time, that this machine connects people. So and in this piece of music I try to show you all the soul of the violin, and it's for my friend Giorgio that requested it. So I'm ready. Thank you. I played it only, I guess, one time at Sunday with Mary at the beginning of our experience last April, 1 year and 3 months ago. So a long time ago. So I was happy to play it again. Yeah. Thank you to my friend that requested it. And thank you for listening, everybody.
Thank you, Mike.
So great. We really do wish you were here.
We really, really do wish you were here.
Oh, yes, yes. Me too, as you know. And please remember to say hi to all my friends there. And I will be there next year, I really hope. because they are really friends. Ciao, ciao.
We ciao, ciao. You. Ciao, ciao, Michele.
Ciao.
Ciao, ciao. Right. Jamie Harris, would you grace us with a song?
Sure.
What are you going to do, Boomerang Town?
I feel like.
Let's do it. This is a.
It won't be exactly like
record. This is a title track from Jamie's forthcoming record, which is being mixed and mastered right now. And Betty Sue sang harmony in the studio on this, and I have the great privilege of hearing this track. And the harmony background vocals on this, on the recording, are unbelievably moving. It's a moving song, but the accompanying vocals to your incredible lead vocal are astonishingly beautiful.
Thank you.
I mean that from the bottom of my heart. Let's give it a go.
Sure. All right.
Working at the supermarket when I fell for Julie, knocked her like everybody said I would. The day I turned 16, I got that job. Thank you.
Let's go and start flying. As for me, the only dream I've ever had is getting out of this boomerang town. It feels like soaring, it feels like flying. Now I know it's only dying. You spend in circles, round and round in this boomerang town.
Yeah. Oh, thanks for singing with me, Betty Sue.
Yeah.
Thank you. And thanks for singing on my record.
Thank you.
And
for
thanks
asking
for singing
me.
On my last record too.
Well, thanks for asking me.
Oh my gosh.
Such a great song.
Thank you. Thanks for saying that.
I love it. I love that song so much.
I do too. I think that song's gonna go out in the world and find people that really need it.
I think I told you at La Posada, like, don't get sick of this song because people are going to request it for the rest of your life.
Yeah.
You did say that. I wrote it about it in my diary. Literally did.
It's definitely one of
those. It might have been my favorite thing in my work play every day.
Oh, best thing
planner.
Today.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Staying with it. Staying with that diary.
Yeah.
Well, where are we, Betty Sue?
Betty Sue.
We got time. You play a couple for us?
Sure. Oh, please. Sure. Okay. Well, I think I might do a brand new.
Awesome.
Brand new song.
Brand new is great.
Bring you back in here.
Oh, right.
What a treat. A premiere.
Okay. Hello again. Okay. Well, I'm kind of all in nobody's girl land, and so it's been weird to like focus at all on my own stuff, and but I've got some stuff in the works for me too, and I've been really grateful to Matt the electrician because he runs this song game.
Oh yeah.
So, and he gives us a prompt every week, and then everybody in the group's got to write a song and send it in. And if it weren't for that, I don't know that I would get my writing done every week that I need to do. So I'm grateful to Matt. This was a real recent one that he sent out. Brand new. That's how new it is. Thank you.
Summer's breath grows heavy. The sunsets creep closer every night in the city. The heat makes me ready. To fall into the fading of green, into bright, brilliant colors that signal an end. Strange shape, street shadows I see from my window.
Debut. Not used to playing it yet, but
it's, everyone loves it on the comments.
But thanks for having me on your show, Mary.
It's always my pleasure.
Thank you. They were excited, whoever that was that drove by. All right. Well, I'll end up with one more Nobody's Girl song, since that's what I've been practicing all day and all night.
Colorado, turned out the light.
That's already out. Is that out right?
Just came out this last weekend. Yeah.
I love.
Is that the single?
Sorry. Well,
it's a single.
It's a single. It's a
single. Yeah, I bet that rocks.
Thank you.
I bet it rocks with drum kit and bass.
It's fun with a band and with all three singers, you know.
Yeah.
It's
big.
I love that song.
Yeah.
Thank you. Yeah. I should ask you to sing it with me if you know it. Darn. Oh, well.
I think I was accidentally singing a little bit.
That's good. I'm glad.
Well, thank you for being our host and our guest
today. Thank you so much.
And
so great to see you guys.
We're excited about what's next, which is something called Maple Creamies. We're going to an ice cream shop here in Bellows Falls, and I've never had a maple creamy. It sounds New England-y and good.
It's a Vermont specialty.
It's a soft serve ice cream?
Yeah, made with real maple.
Great.
And that's hard to find stuff like experiences that you haven't had.
You've been everywhere. I've done everything.
And you're a chef, so you've eaten all this food. This is like, I'm so stoked.
A new thing. We'll be at the Maple Creamy stand in about 20 minutes. But for now, we're going to close out with a song or two. Thanks, everybody, for being with us today. Have a good Independence Day. I think we are going to go home tomorrow, fly back to Nashville. We're home for 2 days. Sad, I know. And then we're going to Atlanta. We have two shows in Atlanta. The first show is sold out. The second show has seats. Then we're going to Amelia Island. There's a tropical storm headed up from the Caribbean, and we're keeping our eyes on it because Amelia Island is in northern Florida, but I think we'll miss it by a day if the tracking is right now. And we'll do a store appearance at a bookstore and a show as well out there. And so we'll be on the road quite a bit coming up and looking forward to all that. Playing bookstores where I'll both read and play songs Tuesday night. If you're not doing anything, look up our live stream from Parnassus Bookstore. I think it costs $30 to sign on, but you get a book, and I believe they're signed. I'm not in charge of that one, but Parnassus Bookstore in Nashville, Tennessee is hosting myself and Allison Moorer, a singer-songwriter, who will be interviewing me.
Another great author.
Yeah.
Oh, she's such a good writer. She's an incredible songwriter, and her books are extraordinary. So we'll be doing that, and then the following week I'll be doing a live stream for a Seattle bookstore, and Brandi Carlile will be interviewing me, which is exciting. So I've got some stuff coming, and we'll let you know about it. If you're not on my email list, please sign up at my website, marygauthier.com. We'll keep you posted what's going on. And there's a lot going on. I don't think we're going to do the Sunday live stream next week because we're traveling. But the following week, I'm going to do it myself from a hotel room in Fayetteville, Arkansas. And I'll read some from the book and play some songs for you. And that's it. You got anything else to say, Harris?
I just also want to say thank you a million times to Betty Sue for setting up and running all of this tech and teaching us new tricks and just for being so great and for hosting us and playing games, board games with us last night, vintage board games from the 1970s and 1950s. And this has been, it's just been really great.
It's been a great few days.
And it's always a treat to sing with you because, you know, you're one of my favorite people in the whole world. And so this is it's just creamy on top of creamy. It's just so good.
Well, you know, food, music, and friends. That's the big three.
That's it.
Food, music, and friends. For me, anyway. That's what I love. And thank you all for being a part of the story and jumping on these streams. I think I have time for my father sure could use a little mercy now. The fruits of his labor fall and rot slowly on the ground. His work is almost over, won't be long, he won't be around. I love my father, mercy now. And my brother sure could use a little mercy now. He's a stranger to freedom, shackled to his fear and doubt. It's almost more than living will allow. I love my brother, he could use some mercy now. My church and my country, they could use little mercy now. As they sink into a poison pit, it's gonna take forever to climb out. They carry the weight of the faithful who follow them down. Church and country, they could use some mercy now. Every living thing could use a little mercy now. Only the hand of grace mercy now. Thank y'all. Happy Independence Day. Thank you, Jamie Harris. Thank you, Betty Sue. Thank you, Michele Gazic. I hope you have a good rest of your day wherever you are. And we'll see you in 2 weeks, okay? We're on the road again, so get on my mailing list. If we're coming to your town, we will let you know.
I did want to say, all three of us are going to be at the Woody Guthrie Folk Festival in Okemah, Oklahoma.
All three of us will be at the Woody Guthrie Folk Festival in Okemah, Oklahoma in 2 weeks.
Yeah.
And
it's a blast. So if you're into Woody or just curious about Woody Guthrie or just want to come hang out with us, it is one of my favorite festivals on planet Earth. It is in the lineup this year. So great. It's going to be a really special time.
It's a bunch of friendly folks and guaranteed to be very hot. So wear short shorts. Anyway, we'll see y'all in 2 weeks if we don't see you.
You wear short shorts.
You dare wear short shorts. Dare wear
short shorts.
We love y'all. Take care. We'll see you soon.